Sims Floor final decided, and Diego Hipólito absolutely delighted. And I can assure you that's not his sister. It is his sister. Well, it's good to see they're so close. No, it's fantastic, isn't it? And really, it's somewhat of a changing of the guard. As we look ahead now and we look at the start list for the women's vault final, that is coming up next. Don't forget, still to come also, Monette Russo a little bit later on. But there are some wonderful stories in this group of eight gymnasts. The vault, it's a 25-meter sprint, and like the gymnast, you've got to be quick, or else you'll miss it.
Vaulting is exciting, as it's about acceleration and height. It shows off the gymnast's athletic qualities and begins with a run-up of up to 25 metres. The entry can be either forward or backwards, and can include a twist between 180 and 360 degrees prior to contact with the table. Judges look for a tight body with legs together whilst in contact with the table. They look for dynamic repulsion to gain maximum height and distance for the last phase of the vault. The final phase is a somersault, known as a salto, that can be performed in various positions. A tuck, pike, or layout. These saltos can also include twists. Generally, the more twist, the higher the difficulty and the start value of the vault. The ultimate finish is to land without any movement of the feet or arms. In other words, stuck.
And unlike the all-around, there are two vaults for each competitor. Those two scores are tallied together, and the average is the final result.
There are two critical things, of course. One is the combination of the two start values, so you can give a gymnast a huge advantage with a high start value. And the other critical thing, of course, is your landing position.
Olga Shevatky of Ukraine, with her first vault behind her.
The start value for that was a 9.8, which is quite a good start value at this level. I do believe we're going to see some 10s today, 10 start values. So round off to the board, a backward entry, half turn into it, half turn out, with a back somersault in pike position. For her particularly, I'd say that she needs to show a little bit more lift from the horse. And she does have some leg form errors throughout. So you can see, watch the leg separation first there, and the second time as she's just coming into the landing. So that's quite critical in a vault final. Direction is good. She's right in line with the horse.
And you can see too, the apparatus taking on a new look in recent times, basically for safety reasons. A start value of 9.8 and a score of 9.212. So
and
one to go.
On the left there, you can see the little scoreboard or the screen that says what the vault that she's going to do. It has a number and it has the start value sitting next to it. The judges do know what vault they're going to do before they come down the runway. And Yushchenko with a double twist. So, solid two vaults, and the thing is, we can see definitely see some thrills and spills in this apparatus.
Could you compare? How do you compare the two vaults?
Well, it's they have a judging table of faults, so they look at it between the board and the horse. That's one section. Mm-hmm. They look at it on the horse. The repulsion they get from the horse, that's another section, and then they look at the post-flight for the third section, and finally the landing. So there's deductions for each section of the vault.
Remember, she scored 9.212 for her first vault.
And I just want you to keep in mind the lift that she's got from the horse there, because we're going to compare it directly with another gymnast who's coming up a bit later, who's got the best lift that I've ever seen of any girl off the vaulting table. It's just remarkable.
And that is?
Well, that is the American girl, Alicia Sacramone, but here we go.
Yes, the start value again of 9.8 and a score of 9.212. So I think we can actually work out that average, 9.212.
You're very quick with your maths, Sandy.
here's a great story. Elena Zamolchikova from Russia, 23 years of age. She is the 2000 Olympic champion. She has a great record in the vault in these championships.
One more. Great competitor. And well, she starts with the Yushchenko double twist. So she's got two world titles on this apparatus, 99 and 2002. And, of course, in Australia, the 2000 Olympic title. We can see here some form errors, a little low on the landing. And, of course, the judges will be very picky with body positions. They're looking for complete stretch of the hips throughout. And here we can see she has just a small pike in the hip. So that's a break at the line of the hip that the judges will penalise her for. Directionally, it's good. And distance-wise, it's fine. I think she could just about do this vault in her sleep. She's competed it so many times.
...9.8 start value and a score of 9.287. So a better start than the Shabatki, but still one but vault to come.
...9.9 start value for this. So, two vaults to her feet, and that's a harder vault. It's judged at a 9.9. It's a double twist off the horse, but it's a half turn onto the horse. It's a what they call a Sukahara entry. Let's wait for her to come through. It's harder to get the rotation in that sort of entry to the horse than it is from a Yushchenko, which is a backward entry, hence a higher start value. So, half on, needs a good push. Similar errors to before, a little bit of directional problems there. So we see the same body faults in the hips and a little bit of leg separation. Happens in a split second. It's amazing how they can maneuver their body so quickly.
Start value and a score and average. Brings it out to 9.318, and she has the lead. 9.318 to Zamolchikova. Shabatki, 9.212. And now, Joanna Skoronska.
Now this is interesting.
Poland.
Poland's only ever had one girl in a vault final before. That was in 1950, and she came first. That was the first year women had the world championships. So she's got it. Tough act to follow, isn't she?
Fair incentive, though, to break a 55-year drought.
Well, that's very nice. A little bit lower start value, 9.7. It's a 1.5 twist, but it had good amplitude. Nice lift from the horse. That's what vaulting's all about. It's about dynamics. Tiny bit off direction. That comes from when they do the round off. They don't actually place their hands down straight in front of them, and that carries through to the second half of the vault. Just see here, she's just got a little bit off direction coming onto the horse.
Is there one apparatus, Liz, that is more difficult to judge than others?
I think bars is hard because it's so complicated and so many hand changes and so on.
9.15 is the score with a start value of 9.7.
But vault's quick, so you have to really look closely to see the differences between one gymnast and the next.
Needs a good one here.
And a very tidy vault that was. Round off to the board again. And the half turn on, front half off. half on, sets it up nicely, spots the ground. You can see where she's going to land for quite some time. You can see the little red mat on the floor there before the board. That's just for hand protection. It just softens it up a bit. And some of the gymnasts were getting sore wrists from placing their hands down from that great speed onto the vault runway.
Joanna appearing in her third World Championship, 16th in the vault 3 years ago. She's had extensive World Cup experience, and there are 9.7 start value and a score of 9.162. That's not enough to catch a Zavalchukova. That leaves her in third place.
Now we're in for a treat here. And
here is Alicia Sacramone of the United States.
And the contest is going to be between her and Cheng Fei, but check this out. Whoa, great height. Now her Achilles heel, so to speak, is her actual control of the landings, because she's got such massive amount of power that she's got to time it perfectly to land it well. Look how high she gets off the horse. Push. And that big hop backwards, which can be the difference between that and a gold for her. A massive vault. And if you'll remember a couple of gymnasts ago watching another girl do a double twist, you can see the difference in the amplitude.
While we're watching this 17-year-old in action, a reminder too that coming up shortly on the uneven bars, another 17-year-old from Australia, Monette Russo. That's coming up shortly.
Now her second vault is a very, very difficult one. I've only ever seen one other girl compete this, and it's a
9.387, Liz, I'm sorry.
It's a handspring front, 1.5 twist in layout position, and has a 9.9 start value, so she's already ahead from the other gymnast just with a start value, but it's an awesome vault. Oh!
Yeah. The height she gets, as you say, is quite extraordinary. Coach is very, very excited by that.
She's won a stack of vaulting titles over the last year and a half at various World Cup and Continental Championships, but the only fault with this vault is it's a bordering on a bit short. She's just in front of, just behind the white line. So she's hitting up the front of the horse. And once again, tiny lack of control on the landing. But what she has trouble with the landing, she certainly makes up for in the dynamics department.
She is the American national champion on this apparatus. I think her coach thinks she could well be a world champion after that vault. 9.387 for her first, 9.412 for her second. That puts her in first place. So Sacramone takes over the lead from Zamolchikova with Shabatsky in third. Now, Oksana Chusovitina, what a record this marvellous gymnast has from 91 to 2003. She's been in every World Championship, second, third, third, fifth, second, third, and first. And believe it or not, in between time, she had time to have a baby.
She's certainly a remarkable gymnast. This is her eighth World Championships, and every single one of them she's been in the vault final. Same vault as Sacramone, actually. No, sorry, she's done it slightly differently. Handspring layout, 1.5 twist, but she sets it up differently. So 9.9 start value. Actually, it is exactly the same vaults as Sacramone. Some leg form errors. She's got better distance. She's 30 years of age, the most popular woman on the gymnastics circuit.
Now, start value, as Liz said, 9.9. And a score of 9.437. That is very, very good.
And that's exactly the same score that Sacramone got for her vault, the same vault.
So she needs to beat 9.387 to take the outright lead.
Wouldn't it be remarkable if she gets another medal? 1991, a time span of 13 years and medalling steadily all along the way. 14 years. It's good.
Alicia Sacramone knows it's good. And she applauds her.
And Chusevita now lives in Germany. Just doing so well. And she says she'll make it. She's certainly trying for Beijing, and she'll make a decision after that whether she'll carry on for London. But early representation was with USSR, then of course in 92 for CIS, and now competing for Uzbekistan.
When do you think she'll retire?
Well, anyone's guess.
Here comes the score. Catapults her into first place. 9.418. She leads by 6 thousandths of a point from Alicia Sacramone of the United States. Uzbekistan first, USA second, Russia third. And now this is Fei Xing from China.
Now this is quite remarkable. She is attempting two vaults, both with a 10 start value. So already she's 3 tenths ahead of Chusevita and Sacramone before she even starts. But the key is, of course, she's got to land them both successfully.
This competition is just getting better and better.
Now that was worth 10. It's a Yushchenko. It's 2.5 twists. Adds an extra half twist on than anybody else has done at these championships, and just about a perfect landing. Gets great contact position, perfect hip stretch, everything.
Well, is a perfect 10 out of the question tonight?
Well, if I was judging, it wouldn't be, but I don't think the judges here are going to award that. They'll find something.
Comes the score. She's done remarkably well. There you saw the start value, but a score of 9.725.
Now she's creating history with this second vault. It's a vault that's never been performed by a woman before at a World Championship or Olympic Games level. Only the men have been performing it. It's a round off onto the board, a half turn onto the horse, and 1.5 twists off in a stretch position.
Let's see how she goes. Bring on Beijing 2008, they're saying.
She's a star, isn't she? Half turn on, stretches it, 1.5 twist off. She competed this about a month ago at a competition, had a lot of troubles with it, so I suppose she's a bit worried coming into this competition. But certainly extraordinary to have 20 out of 20 start value.
I mentioned Monet Rasso coming up shortly, so too on the men's pommel is Prathan Seljuthrai of Australia. The 19-year-old is getting ready. And look at this score. Start value we know is 10, a score of 9.656. And she is threatening to blow this field away on this particular apparatus.
Well, it's looking like Chuzovitin is going to end up with a medal because she's in second spot at the moment and only two girls to go.
One of them is Anna Pavlova.
From Russia.
Well, certainly Pavlova is also a very good vaulter, so don't count her out of the medals either. A little bit off direction.
The Russians a very good record in recent times on this apparatus in this championship. Gold medalists in 99, 2001 and 2002.
A little bit off direction. You can see she's just contacting the horse and then travelling to her left. Her mother, her coach. Very hard to watch and coach, I should imagine. Know of at least five combinations here of parents coaching their daughters at this World Championships. Three in the US women's team, Anna Pavlova and of course Fabian Hambüchen from Germany as his father coach him.
9.8 start value, 9.25 the score. One vault to come.
She'll have to put a good vault in to get ahead of Zamolodchikova, and I think she's not going to be in the medals today. 9.8 start value again.
So there's the work of Anna Pavlova, the 18-year-old from Russia, in her second world championship.
Half on, front half off. Lacking some height, definitely needed more repulsion from the horse. Seemed to get a bit cramped in there, in the handstand position.
So at the moment, Fei Sheng leads with this mighty score of 9.656. There's the final score on the right of Pavlova, 9.237. She won't figure in the medals. Sheng almost certainly will win the gold. Imogen Cairns is still to come. She is the final competitor from Great Britain. Just a youngster, 16 years of age, so a big moment for her.
And this is the first time we've seen a girl from Great Britain in a vault final in World Championships history. Yushchenko with a 1.5 twist.
So Sheng is safe. Chuzovitina now is feeling she's got the silver medal, and Elisa Sacramone the bronze medal.
Just see a little bit of a stiff-legged landing here. And some small form errors, and of course the directional problem there, probably a 0.2 deduction, travelling sideways quite a bit.
Just a reminder, the men's pommel coming up shortly, and of course Australia's Prathanth Seljuthrai getting ready to take on the world's best. Now the score there for Imogen, 9.012, starting value of 9.7, and her final vault.
Of course, they have to show two different vaults. So, start value of 9.5 there, so our leaders are safe.
Our gold medalist is very, very safe. And there she is, Fei Sheng. That's just an extraordinary performance, and also a great story surrounding Oksana Chuzovitina.
Here we can see Asukahara in a pike position, so the second vault a little bit lower value, or quite a bit lower value, so not giving her a chance, but well done for reaching the vaulting finals. Great Britain's having a great championships here.
That is just an amazing performance. There's the final score for Imogen on her second vault, 9.5 and 8.956. So there is is our vaulting champion for 2005. And she has given us something to remember. Two incredible vaults.
Please put your hands together for our competitors as they leave the arena.
So here are the standings following the final of the women's vault. Fei Shang of China, a mighty effort, 9.656. Oksana Chusovitina, the silver, 9.418. And Elisa Sacramone of the USA, a 9.412. So there it is. Now we turn our attention to the next apparatus. And in a moment, the first Australian with quite an incredible story to tell.